And I'd like to invite up Ken Saka to the stage. Hopefully many of you had the chance to be in the community room this morning and hear from him. But he is a missionary, and as so many of you know, we have been able to help provide the Book of Luke and the Sangha, the people of Sangha, in their heart language, the Book of Luke. Well, he has spent time with those people, and so he's going to get an opportunity to share a few minutes about that. So thank you for being here, Ken.
Thank you so much. Praise God. Is this on, brother? Okay. Sue and I have been missionaries for over 30 years by God's grace, and it's not anything that we have done, but it's what God, Jesus has done through us. It's what he's doing through his church. I said in the Sunday school, I'll say it again, we would never go overseas as foreign missionaries if people are not praying, and we can't go if you don't send us. What remains in the world of Bible translation, and the Bible, by the way, has been translated into more languages than any other book, but what remains is the remote, the distant, and the difficult. And one of those groups that this body of Christ is reaching is the Sangha people. In 2019, I visited the Sangha people many times. They are 9 hours to the north of where Sue and I live in Zambia. But in 2019, a particular story I want to tell you is that I was there during a very hot time of the year. And we had just finished the Gospel of Luke. And when I say we, I mean we together, the body of Christ. You guys are helping to fund this through your sweat and tears. But we just finished the Gospel of Luke, and I had it on my phone, and I was trying to give it to people, trying to Bluetooth it from phone to phone. Cell phones are very popular in Africa, even in remote areas where there's no electricity. I was trying to Bluetooth it to people and share with them the good news of Jesus, so they could hear the Gospel of Luke. And I was in the center of a town called Chifunda, very remote place. They have no electricity there, no running water. It's a little town. And there was these three bars blaring out ungodly music. And the thought occurred to me, why not go and put it on the bar's sound system? I went up to the first bar owner, and I said, would you listen to this? And I had Luke playing on my phone. She could hardly hear it. I said, could you turn down your sound system so that you could listen to it? She turned it down. She listened to it, and she said, that's my language. That's Sangha. I said, yeah, that's the Bible, right? I said, you know, I could put this on your sound system. Would you like me to do that? She said, yes. Now, I had never done anything like this before. I didn't know what I was doing, but she gave me the sound card. I put it into my laptop, and I was scrolling through about 300 ungodly songs. And don't tell her, but I had to delete about three of them to fit the Gospel of Luke on there. Put it on there, put it back in her sound system, and we shuffled through and found it. And now the Gospel of Luke is playing. And men who had come early in the morning, 9 o'clock in the morning, to get drunk, this despairing of life, now heard words of life being played. I went to the second bar, and the exact same thing happened. I asked them if I could put on the sound system. They agreed. And a third bar. And now at any time of the day, the gospel, the word of God can be broadcast there in this little town. They don't have electricity, but they're using solar panels and batteries to gather enough electricity. And the word of God is being played from those bars in the town of Chifunda because of what God has done through you. And God's word brings hope and light. We are hearing wonderful reports. I only have time this morning to tell you one other story. It's the story of Mayaka. Mayaka was dependent upon her older sister. People live in great poverty there, and her older sister was the only one who had a real job. She was a teacher. And her sister died. And when her sister died, Mayaka was in great despair. She thought of killing herself. She thought, well, first I'll go and drink my worries away. She began drinking, and this just caused her to be angry. One time in anger, Mayaka took her sister's picture and destroyed it and said, why did you leave me? Mayaka knew that she was at her wit's end, and she asked people to pray for her. And word got to our Bible translation office there in the town of Chama. And one of our translators, Bertha, who I know personally. Bertha went to pray with Mayaka. Bertha went there, listened to Mayaka's story, and she felt led of God. Bertha felt led of God to play for Mayaka. I believe it was Luke chapter. Chapter 8, the story of the demoniac, when Jesus cast the demons out of the demoniac. She played the Gospel of Luke chapter 8 for her, and she had her listen to it, and she asked Mayaka, could you repeat back to me the story? Mayaka did. And then Bertha asked Mayaka the question, if God can deliver this man from the demons that tormented him, the God who created you, can he not also help you in your situation, deliver you from the demons that are troubling you? Mayaka began to cry, and she received Jesus Christ as her Lord that day. Because somebody back here in Overland Park was praying, because somebody decided this is something worth giving to. Somebody received Jesus Christ. And there are hundreds and hundreds of people coming to Christ because of the word of God among the Sangha people. God is using you. And I just want to encourage you to continue to fulfill your purpose here all over this county, all over this city, and to the ends of the earth. I want to show you a short video. It's just 3 minutes long. It shows a little bit of glimpse of life in Zambia. My wife, Sue, would stand. My wife is working among Muslim women in eastern Zambia. You'll see several of those women baptized on this video, and you'll see me working with the Bible Translation Project. But thank you so much for, I've learned in life to thank God, not so much thank people, but thank God for his faithfulness through you. Amen.
Stays the same. Heaven is waiting for the mention of the name. The Spirit is moving, burning like a flame, healing the broken by the one we proclaim. Oh, Jesus.